But at the light office, she was just looking at our legs, really. She wasn't really interested in the scene. I thought about all these things, and then one day, about two Christmases ago, on about the 20th of December, I got a phone call from Mrs. Abrams' sister. And she said, my sister would like to talk to you. And I thought, this is a really wonderful moment. I'd like to make contact with this woman who taught me all those years ago. And you know, being a writer is really difficult things because you people are shopping here in Sandton. And I was busy making contact. This was serious stuff for me, you know? We writers work up to Christmas time. So I phoned her, and she lives in Durban now. And I made the phone call. Her sister gave me the phone number, and I made the call. And her husband, whose name is Jan, whom I'd never met before, who's also a retired school teacher, he answered the phone. And I said, may I speak to Mrs. Abrams, please? And he said, who shall I say is calling? Now, this was a problem, because now I wanted to surprise the woman. I wanted to tell her first. I didn't want her to hear it from him. Hey, guess who's here on the phone? I wanted to tell her myself. But now this is a dilemma, because you guys know that if a guy says, who shall I say is calling? You can't say, no, I'm not going to tell you. You can't say that. Especially if you wrote in a book, I'm going to marry Mrs. Abrams. Because he might think this is me coming to get mine.